Hey Noob, how's it going? What is... Oh my fucking god. Oh my fucking god. Time do you start work, Noob? Hampden Park. 10 AM. So that's 9 hours, loads of time. So I've set the speed control to hold us at 25 mph while I've put on full power. As we're on a 25 mile an hour limit, which is going to change to 70 soon, and then we take off the speed set. There's our 70 marker. We've got 8 coaches on. That's indicated there by the little 8 marker. Train length 8. All coaches have gone past that marker. And we turn off the speed set. That's to keep us awake in the ding before that, as for the signals clear. There's our marker, so we turn off speed set, or cruise control as people like to call it. Turn on the cab, oh that's a notice board light, cab light. Right, 1.4 miles, here we go. Hey Alex, how's it going? Alex, work at 7.30 wake up. Are you sure that one, Riddler? 7.30 wake up? It's a bit early for a 10 o'clock start, isn't it? Why has the settings changed? I didn't have that on there before. I have to change that, I think. Oops, wrong button. It's telling me the distance, the station on the screen. I'd rather it be in the top left corner, how I usually like it. I'm going to take the power off. And get ready to stop. Break one. Riddler says yes because of trains, Noob. Oh. Time. Oh, I need to change the settings here. That's the wrong button. Oh, dearie me. I don't know why that's changed back. Stop marker. We need objective marker. Fuck's sake. Oh no, don't need that. Stop my objective marker off. That's what we need. Yeah, that's better. Just loading passengers here. Super noob, a loop, super noob, says Riddler, noob. Riddler's a noob. Alright, Noob, no worries. You go to sleep. Full power from the start. Why not? A noobie noobie loop. A noobie noobie looby loop. Loop. What? 2.2 miles to the next station, Polegate. Got to arrive there in 4 minutes. A little ding says that the signal ahead of us, immediately ahead of us, is green, which it is there. Right, the noob's gone. Ah, Jordan is asking me for coming back. Making sure we're alive. That beeping noise is the dead man handle switch, which is at our feet that you can press, even though our feet are invisible in the game. Slowing down for this 35 mile an hour speed limit round the bend here, and also the station's almost after the bend. I think it bends around to the left and then there's the station, so we're getting ready for that as well. So we're coasting now. That little number below the speedometer on the head-up display, not the actual physical train, but that number on the head-up display that's below the number 31, that's how much power or brake we're applying. Because it's zero, means that we're applying no brake, no power. Gonna just accelerate it a little bit for the slight uphill that we're on. That's why the number below the speedo has now gone to a white number one. That means the white numbers below the speedo means that we are accelerating, and the yellow numbers means we're braking, and the zero means we're doing neither acceleration or braking. So there's the speed limit marker going back up to 90, but we're stopping at this station. So we've taken off the power one and we're getting ready to brake. And Alex, do you remember when Ben, I think, put the train in drive and jumped? Probably Mikey did that. Yeah, that was Mikey. Alright, coming up to the station, Polegate. Going to apply brake notch 1. Getting ready for the ping of the signal. There it is. Are we still a little bit too fast? It looks alright to me. Going to take one off and coast here to the end of our stop marker. Are we on time? We are indeed. We're bang on. We got to get here at 11:46 in the game, and we've literally stopped at exactly 11:46. Open some doors. So on this head-up display speedo, there's a clock there with the timing. That's the current time. And then when we're moving, it will say in the top left the time that we need to get to our next station. So it's Polegate. With a green light ahead of us, which is nice, and also a level crossing that we'll have to horn for. Passengers are almost loaded, so getting ready to close the doors. We're good to go. So check the signal again, it's green and then full power. The speed limit is 90 mile an hour. We're coming over a level crossing. A little bit of a horn for that. Full power. Is how long the train is. It's quite long. Going slightly uphill. We're going to get the DSD warning in a moment, which is the quick succession beeping that makes sure that we've pressed one of the controls, most of the controls, within the last minute. If not, we have to cancel that audio alarm. There it is, AWS, correction, we call that DSD or vigilance. So if you pass out, if you go unconscious and you're driving this train, that's the signal green, by the way, that ping there, that little ding, and the signal's green. Yeah, if you pass out and you have a heart attack behind the train, every 60 seconds that little beep will go off unless you've pressed one of the main controls on the train that control its movement, in which case every time you use one of the main controls, it will reset that 60 second timer. If you don't touch any controls for 60 seconds, that beep will go off, and if you don't cancel it within about 4 seconds, the train brakes are automatically applied. So if you have a, in the real world, if you have a heart attack, but you know, behind, you know, the controls, on the controls, the train will stop within 60 seconds, and it's an emergency brake application. It's not just gentle brakes, it's quite hard. Right, I've just backed off the power here. Again, signal green for the ding. I've backed off the power because we're going downhill with a 75 mile an hour speed limit coming up just before the station. So I'm just going to coast here down the hill. Which are better, trains or trams? Trains are safer because they're not on public roads. But trams do go a lot slower, so any incidences with trams are usually, nobody dies. With trains, especially the speeds that these trains go in this current situation, we're doing almost 90 in the real world. Any incident with a car could be catastrophic, or a pedestrian or whatnot. So we're going to back off for the station with brake notch 2 at 0.7 miles for the station. Also our speed limit coming up right before the station. Getting ready for the ding there for the signal that's green. So it's slowing down nicely there. Going to take it from brake 2 to brake 1. So we're slowing down less. So brake 1 is the least amount of brake. Then brake 2 is the medium. And then brake 3 is the most amount of brake. And then brake 4 is emergency brake. So I'll put it into brake 2 now as we're coming in a little bit too quick for me. And then brake 3 as we're still a little bit too quick. Which is good, going back to 2, as it says on the bottom right hand corner, 1 and off. Off is no brake, no acceleration, so just coasting in now. Our arrival time, which is shown in the top left hand corner, 11:51. We're actually 30 seconds early, so we should expect to be held here for a little bit. Brake 1 for the slowdown on the end of the platform. That's a ship view, that's also a ship view. Let's go back to that view. Brake 1, and we can open the doors. The train is long. This is a class 377. Sure, an S car stopped there. There's a wrong signal, the wrong sign. Ah, don't give me this. Oh, don't give me this. Why are the doors open? Oh, is the game glitched? Oh no, it's not. It's me. There we go. here, destroyer.
Mm-hmm.